is called microevolution, which we subscribe to. This is evolutionary change below the level of species. Alright? Macroevolution is between species, and microevolution is within the species. For example, this is the dog family. They evolve into another species, but they're still dogs, but they're different kind of dog, right? And the frog also, different species of frog, animal, and horses also. There are horses that are so high, so big, so tall, that ordinary people like you and I, who are Asians, we can't even climb it, even if there's a saddle and for you to climb up. It's so huge. But then there are also species of horses that are so small, like a dog. It's been bred for aesthetic reasons for us, for people, the wealthy ones, to buy and keep as pets for the children to play with. But it is bred by human beings, like goldfish, you know. This is microevolution. Do we accept that? Yes. It's microevolution. Do we accept that it's within the same family? But macroevolution is evolution from one species to another higher form of species. The different kind of fowls, right? Different kind of dogs, different kind of horses. This is still dog, although they look different, it's still within the dog family. And the theory of evolution, the violates known scientific law, for example, the second law of thermodynamics, also known as the law of entropy. And this is basically saying that organization and complexity is descending into disorganization and chaos. It's something that happens in life every day, right? Every day in life we see this, right? There's a hotel, for example. I asked how long and how new is this hotel? And before, by the staff, they said it's about 6 years old, right? So in the beginning, when they first built this hotel, it looked brand new and very nice. But now it's 6 years old. And as time passes on, it will be 16 years old. And then it will be 16 years old. And you can see the difference. It's getting older and older. We buy a brand new shirt, it looks nice. Even if you don't wear it, you leave it and cover it. And 5 years later, you bring it out. Never been worn before. You can tell it's old already. This law works in every aspect of our life. When organization and complexity is descending, it's going down. It's becoming a mess. It's becoming chaotic, right? But evolution, on the other hand, goes against this law, where they say in the beginning there was disorganized form, and later on, over time, it's going to improve itself and become more organized. First, simple cell animal, very simple, it moves. And over millions of years, it becomes multi-cell. And then later on, it's going to become a fish, then it's going to become an amphibian, then it's going to become an animal, and then eventually a human being. So that violates the second law of thermodynamics, and that cannot be true. Isaac Asimov, Russian-born American author, professor of biochemistry at Boston University. All right, his definition of the second law. Another way of stating the law then is this. Now, this is a scientist explaining what the law is. He says the universe is constantly getting more disorderly. So the universe is also slowing down, getting cooler. Scientists are saying now the sun is not as hot as it was. So eventually, the world is going to slow down, and it agrees with the scripture. The Bible says that one day the world, the earth will burn up. It will be burned up. Everything that's in the world will burn up. And it does not violate that law. The second law of thermodynamics also says that things are slowing down. So if you give it time, there is going to be more and more chaotic condition on earth. And we see this in everyday life, for example. In the beginning, when you go to the new room, it was very nice. This represents the big room of some of the young people here, probably. But it becomes chaotic over time, right? And some people's house rooms are really in a mess. But it was not like this in the beginning. If you don't do anything to it, you don't organize yourself, it's going to get worse. A brand new car, you leave it alone for a while, it's going to get old, right? And after some time, it's going to get even worse. That's the second law of thermodynamics. Working, right? This is the definition. He said, in fact, all we have to do is nothing, and everything will deteriorate, collapse, breaks down, wastes out, all by itself. And that is what the second law of thermodynamics is all about. So, evolution contradicts this law. Evolution is the opposite, right? This organized, chaotic, over time is going to get very organized and complex. But this law does not allow it, right? And that cannot be true. The second law of thermodynamics further explains, all things work for themselves always tend to go from the complex to the simple, from the organized to the disorganized. And evolution violates this law. The theory requires building up from the simpler to the more complex. Chaos, disorder. There was a Big Bang, and hydrogen, and helium, and then evolution. That universe is very complex and nice as it is now. Roger Lewin, British anthropologist and science writer. This is what he said. The apparent contradiction by evolution of the second law of thermodynamics. Systems should decay through time, giving less, not more, order. So even scientists themselves admit that the theory of evolution contradicts a known and accepted scientific law, the second law of evolution. So if you represent it in the chart form, this is the evolution model, right? That is this order in the beginning, but over time it's going to get better and better, and resulting in the creation of the evolution of humanity. But the creation model, everything begins in the beginning perfect, but over time things are going to get worse. All right. So how did the first info cell appear? What do the experts say? What do you think they would say? How did this simple cell organism first begins and later on evolve into all the life forms? His explanation. And this is the person who believes in evolution, a professor of molecular biology. The simplest living cell could not have arisen by chance. He is an honest man. But yet evolution says, even time, suddenly, life came into existence, and he disagreed with that. So, here's another scientist. The origin of life is also a stubborn problem with no solution in sight. And here's a scientist who said, we don't know this thing. We don't know how life began. The origin of it is a stubborn problem. We have no answer. And there doesn't seem to be any solution in sight to provide us with the answer. They basically say, we don't know. And evolution is unable to explain the origin of life, therefore it is without foundation. But the Bible is reasonable to accept what the Bible says. The Bible says that God, not any unknown magical event, created life. Now let's look into another category, fossil record. Very interesting, right? What are fossils? Right, let's look at the definition of fossil. Fossil record provides a snapshot of the past. And when the sample is put together, it gives you a panorama of what had happened in evolution over the past 4 billion years. The picture may be smudged in places, but they have bits and bits missing. But fossil evidence clearly shows that life is old and has changed over time. Evolution is a scientific theory used by biology. It explains how animals and plants change over a long time, and how they have come to be the way that they are. The Earth has been around for a long time, and by doing research on the layers of rock, they can find out about the past. And the kind of research is called historical geology. We know that living things have changed over time because we can see the remains in the rock, and these remains in the rocks are called fossils. So fossils are remains in the rock, found in layers of rock underground. They could be remains of animals, or they could be remains of plants. Those are called fossils. So we know that the animals and plants of today are different from those of a long time ago. The further we go back, the more different the fossils are. How has this come about? Because of evolution. So in other words, fossils will support evolution, they say. People who believe in evolution, he said the proofs are found in a fossil. The fossil will tell you that evolution is true. Alright, let's look at that. 5 proofs of evolution in this website. One of the proofs of evolution is the fossil record. The fossil record shows that the simplest fossil will be found in the oldest rocks, and it can also show a smooth and gradual transition from one life form to another. So they believe it. They believe that the rocks in the ground of long ago were proof of evolution. This is something like this. The fossils are preserved remains or traces of animals, plants and other organisms from the past. Okay? So there's something that evolutionists believe in, something that's called the geologic column or the geologic time scale. Right? Scientists accept this. And this is what it's all about. Okay? This is the chart representation of what it is supposed to be. So this is a geologic time scale or a geologic column. See, they have divided the history of the Earth into different time periods. And so they say that if you find a rock that comes from this particular period of time, then the rock is so many million years old. The Earth's crust consists of layers of rock, as called as strata. Each layer represents a long period of time, millions of years. So there is an assumption of this time period that's based on uniformitarianism. In other words, the Earth has always been the same in the past. But we creationists do not believe in that because it is not the same. There was a global flood during the time of Noah that changes the features of the Earth. We believe in something that's called catastrophism. There was a catastrophe, a huge global flood that changes the features of the Earth. The way that the Earth was in ancient days and the way that the Earth is now is not the same. But they believe that the Earth has always been the same. There has been no change. So they say the present is the key to the past. What you see now today, the present, this is what happened in the past, they say. So the fossil remains are unique and they are cataloged and then arranged into a specific order. This order reflects the assumption of macro evolution. The age of the Earth, according to scientists, 4.5 billion years. So where in the world can you find this geologic column? Where in this layer of rock, this life form lived. In this layer of rock, dinosaurs lived. In this layer of rock, human beings begin to exist. Where can you find this geologic column in the whole wide world? This is a British geologist, someone who is against creation. He said that nowhere in the world is the record, or even part of the record, anywhere near complete. In other words, this geology column that they have come up with is not found in nature. It is arbitrarily put together by scientists.